Scott Morrison and Jim Molan. For Scott Morrison, this Jim Molan issue is looming as a major domestic test within the country and the Liberal Party. Let's be blunt. Moves are afoot to ignore Jim Molan's claim to the New South Wales Senate spot to replace Arthur Sinodinos, who's being sent off to Washington. Remember Sinodinos? The bloke whose memory conveniently failed him when he appeared before the New South Wales ICAC. The bloke was the treasurer of the Liberal Party and a director of Australian Water Holdings. But he didn't know as treasurer that Australian Water Holdings had given money to the Liberal Party. I think he couldn't remember about 92 times. I hope when he's being shipped off overseas, he'll be able to remember. Sinodinos is no loss. But now the question must be asked, how can the New South Wales Liberal Party credibly deny Jim Molan a seat in the Senate in the wake of this? Now, I'm talking about the fact that Molan has secured more first preference below the line votes at the May election than any other Senate candidate in history. He's so far attracted almost 120,000 first preference votes, making him the politician with the highest personal vote in the country. He was placed fourth on the Liberals' Senate ticket, an unwinnable position. Those above him on the ticket owe their success solely to their position on the ticket. That's because voters who vote above the line, which is most of us, allow our party of choice to allocate our vote to the people they choose. The New South Wales Liberal Senate candidates above Jim Molan on the ticket didn't attract anything close to Molan's personal vote. Number one on the ticket, Holly Hughes, has so far received a personal first preference vote of 24,000 votes. Number two, Andrew Bragg, has received a personal first preference vote of 2,000. There's another Senate vacancy, Molan, by the way, 120,000. The Senate vacancy for New South Wales Liberal, as I said, following Sinodinos' resignation. Sinodinos' replacement can only be Jim Molan. Molan hasn't just outstripped all Liberal candidates in the personal vote stakes. He's outstripped candidates from all parties by a country mile. His nearest competitor is the New South Wales Labor Senate candidate, Tony Sheldon, with 32,000 first preference votes. Molan now has a massive moral right to the Senate spot that's been vacated. This will be a real test as to whether the Prime Minister plays to the factions or yields to merit. Now, look, on Molan, just remember, this is the man who was the chief of operations of the US-led forces in Iraq in 2004, sent there by John Howard. The most senior Australian officer in any Allied force in combat since the Vietnam War. Senator Jim Molan was under fire in this theatre of war on many occasions. And John Negroponte, later the US Deputy Secretary of State, wrote to Prime Minister Howard to thank him for Jim Molan's service. Negroponte wrote, "Molan made history and helped reshape the Middle East. Jim Molan was awarded the Distinguished Service Cross from Australia and the Legion of Merit by the United States of America. The leadership in federal government is playing with political fire if this man does not secure the Senate replacement ticket on the departure of Sinodinos."